The following video was recorded in June 2020 as part of our Virtual Open Day. The information in the video was correct at the time of recording. For more information on these programs, to arrange a one-to-one discussion with a member of the team, or to apply online, please visit newbury-college.ac.uk.
Hi, my name's Claire, and I'm the Programme Leader for Community Learning at Newbury College. And I'm here with Tanya and Sean, who are two of our course tutors. And we're going to explain a bit more about the courses that we offer. So we offer a wide range of courses for adults who are aged 19 and over. We have one-day workshops, which are held on various Saturdays throughout the year, short non-accredited leisure courses, longer vocational courses, usually with a qualification embedded, and new for the coming academic year, we have some level two qualification courses, which we'll discuss in a bit more detail later in the presentation. And we also run a number of community-based courses in care homes and day centres across West Berkshire, supporting adults with learning disabilities and dementia. Before we get into the other courses, I just want to mention that our courses have been adapted due to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. So the majority of our courses are going to be taught via blended learning. So you will have some face-to-face sessions and some sessions taught online via Microsoft Teams. Select number will be just run online only. And there are a few that will be held as normal face-to-face in the college. But of course, there will be different rules in place just to ensure that we can all adhere to the social distancing guidelines.
Hi everyone, I'm Karen, and welcome to my studio. Had to have a bit of a tidy up as I was doing this video, so I've made myself a temporary backdrop here, which is also serving the purpose of showing you some of my bits and pieces that I do in my courses. So I'm going to be doing acrylics for beginners and drawing for beginners, starting in the autumn at the college. And both of these I'm going to do in small 4-week modules. Starting with absolute basics on both courses. So if you've never done it before and you just really want to know the how-to, to get started, what materials you need, that sort of thing, then that will be the obvious one to get going with. And then all the other modules have been broken up into specific things. So with the painting ones, I've got modules about colour, different techniques, working with other media with the acrylics, and with the drawing ones, I've broken it up into, again, different materials, different subject matter and so on. The reason for doing that was so that you could pick and choose what interested you. And equally, if you have a grounding in the basics already, you could skip that one and just go straight in for any of the other modules. So the way I teach, usually in person, and this is all new to me having to do it online like this, but you know, because of the current circumstances, we've all had to adapt a bit. But the way I teach, I have structure and projects, but it's also quite informal because ultimately this should be enjoyable and fun. You know, painting and drawing is something that we do for leisure and to relax and to just have a bit of time for creativity. So primarily, I want you to go through the process and enjoy the actual making and doing. And along the way, you'll come out with some great bits of work. But that shouldn't be the kind of ultimate goal. That will just happen as you go. I want my classes to be fun for everybody. And we'll do, even if we're doing it online, we'll have feedback sessions. It's always good to not just get my input, but you know, get the group input as well. Hopefully sort of, you know, bring some creativity and, a bit of time for yourselves just to sort of do some stuff during this really weird time that we're going through at the moment. So, and don't worry about the tech. Before all this happened, the only thing I ever did was email, and I've managed to get to grips with all sorts of various tech. And believe me, if I can do it, anybody can do it. So, hopefully I will see some of you in the autumn term. And in the meantime, enjoy this gorgeous weather that we're having. And I'll see you then. Bye.
Hello, I'm Jeanette Cole and I teach art courses at Newbury College. I teach a range of courses which are scheduled for Tuesdays and Thursdays. So there's a drawing and painting course which is on a Tuesday. There's one in the afternoon that starts at 2:30 until 4:30, and there's a repeat of this course in the evening. So that's 7 o'clock until 9 o'clock on Tuesdays. So on this course, you get to explore a range of materials. So that's pencil and charcoal, pastels, ink, watercolours, acrylics, you know, a huge range of materials. And it's lots of fun to explore all of those materials. We also get the opportunity to draw and paint lots of different subjects. So that could be still life, animals, birds, landscapes and faces, you know, portraits. So again, a really good range of subjects are covered as well. So that's the Tuesday courses. You'll get lots of support and feedback, and I'll be giving some live demonstrations as well. And then on a Thursday, we've got an exciting new range of courses planned for Thursday afternoons. So the first one's called Painting Landscapes and Seascapes. And I'm really looking forward to this new course. We'll be using watercolours and pastels and acrylics to paint a range of different seascapes and landscapes. So really, really looking forward to that one. So I hope you're enrolled for it. And then after term A, which is painting the landscapes and the seascapes, it then moves on to a new subject. And it's going to be painting flowers and plants, another subject which I absolutely love. So looking forward to teaching that one. So that's term B on a Thursday afternoon, also 2:30 until 4:30. After this, we then move on to painting animals and birds, which is always a very popular subject. And then finally, we're going to, on a Thursday afternoon again, same time, 2:30 to 4:30, all throughout the year, we're then moving on to doing painting faces and figures. So I'm really looking forward to teaching that one too. So they're all the Thursday afternoon courses that I'll be teaching. But then there's also some really interesting courses planned for Thursday evenings. And these will run from 7 o'clock until 9 o'clock. And the first one in September is called Drawing Techniques. And it's such fun to be able to explore all those different drawing media. So we'll be using pencil and charcoal, ink and pastels, for example, and you get to draw lots of different subjects, and we practice perspective and measuring proportions and shape and form, and it's a lot of fun, and it's really good to improve your drawing practice as well as learning, because all of the courses that I teach at Newbury College, they're for all levels. So whether you're a beginner or whether you're, you know, quite an advanced person, the courses are suitable for everyone, all levels. Okay, so after the drawing techniques course, it then moves on to watercolour painting. And so we get to explore lots of different watercolour techniques, and again, different subjects. So landscapes, portraits, animals, and so on. And then following the watercolour course, we then, term C, we move on to the acrylic painting course. So again, Thursday evening, 7 o'clock until 9, the acrylic painting course gives you a chance to explore this exciting medium. And then finally, in term D, on a Thursday evening, we then move on to a new course, which I'm really excited to teach as well, called Mixed Media Techniques. So, as previously mentioned, you'll get live demonstrations, lots of feedback, one-to-one tuition, and the courses are always so much fun. So I do hope you enrol for September, and I look forward to teaching you all.
Oh,
That was great to hear from Karen and Jeanette. Hello, I'm Sean. I teach the digital technology and computing courses on the community learning programs. And these are really aimed at beginners. So people who are entering the workplace, maybe they've been in the workplace for quite some time, and they just need to practice those skills in Excel, Word, PowerPoint, things like that, that they feel are keeping them back, maybe from progressing in their career or just from doing some of the tasks that they're expected to do. As we move into this time of working from home, working remotely and using more technology, a lot of people are coming to us and saying, I need these skills, I need to improve. So we offer some bite-sized courses in Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Word, and also Office 365, which is the online platform for Microsoft Office Suite. We also offer the 8-week courses, and an 8-week course in Excel and an 8-week course in Word and PowerPoint. That combines a qualification in using Excel or Word with a qualification in using the computer. So you will learn all of the basics about how to manage your files, how to prevent viruses and computer security, as well as both basic and slightly more advanced techniques in Excel, Word and PowerPoint. We also have a social media for business course. This is a 2-day workshop. The first part of the course, we look at how you can use social media for your business. Now, that may be a small business that you run if you're self-employed or running a small business, but also it may be if you're working in an office environment where you're having to use social media as part of your job. So we look at what the different platforms are, how to capitalize on trends. And one of the biggest one people always ask me is how to use a hashtag. So we cover all of those basics. The second part is ideally for people who do run their own small business or are charged with running advertising for the company that they work for. We look at how to set up a business account on Facebook, and how to do paid advertising. So if you do want to advertise, and a lot of people now are moving towards an online platform for advertising, so moving away from traditional things like newspapers, radio, and trying to get that targeted online audience. So we'll be looking at that, how to set it up, what to spend, how to spend it, and how to know that you're getting good value for money. One of the other courses we do, which I don't teach, is photography. That's taught with Victoria, who is our HNC and HND graphics tutor. And she is absolutely fantastic with photography and digital editing. And she can teach you all the different techniques using Photoshop and how to get the most out of your camera and things like that. And hand you back over to Claire now, who will talk to you about the language courses that we offer.
Thanks, Sean. So we offer three different language courses, and these are some of our most popular courses in the community learning department. The three languages we offer are Spanish, Italian and French, and there are different levels for each language. So whether you're a complete beginner or if you have some experience and you'd like to improve your language skills, we'll have a course suitable for you. And all our language courses follow the same format, so they consist of 3 10-week terms spread across the year. And after completing a year at one level, you then move up to the next level in the following September. If you're a bit unsure about which course would be suitable for you, for example, you may have done a qualification, but that may have been a long time ago, and you're not quite sure which level will be best, just get in contact with one of the community learning team, and one of our language tutors can do a quick assessment, and then they'll be able to advise which level is best suited for your needs. We also have some one-day language workshops, and these are designed to help you learn the basics or brush up either your Spanish or Italian skills. So for example, if you're planning to visit Spain or a Spanish-speaking country, and you'd like the opportunity to practice speaking before your trip, these fun and interactive workshops would be ideal for you. So on our next slide, we have a video from Elizabeth, who's our Spanish tutor, and she's got a little bit more information about her courses. And then we've also got some feedback from Andy, who is one of our students currently undertaking a Spanish course with Elizabeth.
Hello, my name is
Elizabeth. Elizabeth.
And I am a Spanish teacher in Newbury College. I'm going to tell you a little bit about conversation class. The conversation class, it is if you have done already GCSE or their equivalent. We have opportunity to, in each lesson, to talk and read about the news, not only in Spain, but in the whole world and from Latin America too. We emphasize and do a little bit of grammar, but more it is opportunity to do conversation and presentations. You will build up and feel more confident and think in Spanish. This is an opportunity to practice with other people, and we have different kinds of tools to develop this beautiful language. We have Moodle, Teams, and all of that will help you to develop in these areas, that is listening, speaking, and writing.
Hola, me llamo Andy. Hello, my name's Andy. I started Spanish for Beginners class at Newbury College in September 2019. My career in languages at school was neither particularly enjoyable or distinguished. However, I have a grandson, Thomas. He's not yet 2 years old, but his father's Spanish. So I thought, well, if I start learning Spanish alongside him, then maybe by the time he's three, I could have a little bit of a conversation with him in both English and Spanish. Well, I think I'm on target to do that, thanks to the way the course is structured and taught. In fact, after only one term, our tutor, Elizabeth, suggested I move up to the intermediate class. Well, I was a bit trepidatious about that at first, but soon quickly settled in to the small group. Everybody's so friendly and very, very supportive of each other. What's really impressive is Elizabeth's a most amazing patience. You know, she's always got time to listen and is never dismissive or critical when you make mistakes. It's just always, well, let's try that again. The course is supported by a whole compendium of online resources, so you can spend as much time as you have available working on things at home. I'm really enjoying the course, and I think I've made really good progress this year, you know, given that I had started from absolute zero. So the question for me now is, when Thomas is 3 years old, will I be teaching him something new, or will he be teaching me?
Hello, my name is Kim Harrison, and I'm an adult and community lecturer at Newbury College. I just wanted to let you know about an exciting program of flower-arranging workshops that will be taking place starting from this October. The workshops are designed for all levels, so if you have some flower arranging skills, it's still a perfect workshop for you to come along to. The workshops will be seasonal and we'll be starting off with an autumn-based workshop. You'll be carving out pumpkins and creating arrangements within the pumpkin, or an autumn-based wreath which can be used for table or door. We'll then be moving on to Christmas door wreaths and Christmas table arrangements. And then through the following year, there will be seasonal hand-tied workshops, following on with some classic designs. At all of the workshops, we will provide all your materials. So you will have the flowers, the greenery, the secateurs, the wires. Of course, if there's something that you want to bring along, you're more than welcome to do so. The format for the workshops will be that we will have a general introduction where we will talk about the flowers and foliage that you'll be using and refer to other seasonal flowers so that you will always be able to use that arrangement shape at a different time of the year. I will then give a short demonstration of the arrangement, and then it'll be time for you to create that special arrangement. I will be on hand all of the time to help you and answer any questions that you have. These workshops are ideal to come along on your own or to come with family and friends. They're aimed at being fun and going home with something that you have created for yourself. Look forward to seeing you at one of the workshops. Bye for now.
So as well as the flower arranging courses at Newbury College, we also have a range of other craft courses available. One of them is a one-day needle felting course, where you can discover the wonderful craft of needle felting, learn the basic skills required to make your own needle felted project. So do have a look at that. We also run a creative clay course. This is an 8-week course and it's aimed at beginners, where we will learn hand building techniques, glazing techniques, and to create functional and decorative pieces of ceramics. I'm actually the tutor for that course. So my name is Tanya Reed and I teach a variety of creative clay courses and workshops during the day and evenings at the college. These are aimed at beginners, but you are also able to stay on and advance at your own pace after you have learnt all the required techniques and skills on the first and the second course. We cover all of the hand building techniques, just slab building, press moulding and coiling. We learn decorative techniques such as relief work, sculpting, impressing, etching and sgraffito. You will also learn how to pull handles, how to use glazes and underglazes, and also about the different stages of clay and firing temperatures. We also do an introduction to throwing on the course, where you will learn the basics of how to make pottery on the wheel. It's a really fun and relaxing environment and also very enriching. There's a real sense of experimentation where students learn through trial and error. They also learn and be inspired by each other. So it's a really, really fun and relaxed course. So I hope to see some of you on that. The other courses we offer are sewing and dressmaking. Courses. We do a one-day workshop on visible mending workshop, where you can explore the exciting techniques of visible mending and darning and discover how to repair your favorite old garments and give them a whole new life. Machine sewing for beginners is a 4-week course. This is designed for complete beginners to learn basic sewing techniques, including zips, seams, and hems. And there's an advanced dressmaking course, which is an 8-week course, where you will be able to create a unique item of clothing from a pattern and fabric of your own choice with expert guidance from the tutor, Kim Broughton.
Welcome. My name is Mary Cruikshank, and I am the ballroom and Latin American dance tutor at Newbury College. This year, for the year of 2020 and 21, we have a very exciting program planned for the Ballroom and Latin American Dance. We offer 6 evening classes, ranging from the beginners through to improvers to the intermediate and the advanced levels for Ballroom and Latin American Dance. We also have on offer this year exciting workshops on a Saturday, and this year it covers the Charleston workshop, a Viennese waltz workshop, the slow foxtrot workshop, ballroom dance taster workshops, and ballroom and Latin American extra workshops for developing your skills in your dancing. Some of these classes are for people who have never danced before, and it's a good opportunity to embark on a journey of ballroom and Latin American dancing. Also on special offer this year, we are offering the wedding dance program, which is in March, and this is for couples who are thinking about dancing their first beautiful romantic dance at their wedding. Now today, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about a beginner's course and what is on offer on the beginner's course. So in the beginner's course, what we tend to teach is 3 dances in the first course, which is the waltz, the social foxtrot, and the cha-cha. And all these dances are ideal if you're at in the party scene to be able to be danced. Now, in the course itself, what you'll be learning is about timing, movement, and posture. and you will be learning the difference between ballroom style and a Latin American style of dance and what that entails. And the other ingredient that we spend time learning is about partnering skills. This one is so, so important. This is about the leaders learning their responsibilities and the followers learning their responsibilities. So the idea is that two people are moving together, and what we want to see is the two people look like one person. So it looks like a perfect, natural, easy movement. That is what dancing is all about. And it's also having some fun. Also in the course, we will handle timing and the music. So in the college, when we do all our dance classes in the evening, what is on offer you get with the courses, you know, schedule of what you're going to learn. You also get handouts to help you remember the moves and the steps. We also have routines which are typed up for you as handouts. And we also have a very special feature. It's called the Moodle. This is an online teaching resource for the students who have access to it. And on this Moodle, we have short little videos of the dance steps to help you remember what you've been taught in the classrooms. Overall, and the feedback I receive from many students, is the courses are fun. It helps improve their well-being and fitness. And they just can't believe they're actually moving to music in time. So if you're interested in the ballroom and Latin American dancing, please give the college a call, and hopefully I will see you in the future. Thank you and have a good day now. Welcome. My name is Mary Cruikshank, and I am the Confidence Building Tutor at Newbury College. This year, we are offering the Confidence Building course two times as a daytime class at the college. Now, this course is about a journey to discover what is confidence. Now, I want to give you a little thought to think about. Imagine you're at a tennis game, and you've got two players on the court passing the ball back and forth, and you've got people sitting in the stands. Now the question is, people sitting in the stands are watching the two people on the court that are passing the ball back and forth, which is called the game of life. Are you one of the people that's sitting in the stands that is just watching the game of life, or are you on the court passing the ball back and forth? Have a little think about that. Another example about the journey of confidence is you're going up to a door, and at this door is knocking to you an opportunity. Now, are you the type of person that's carrying this bag on your back, which is called the baggage, and you come to the door and the opportunity knocks and you say yes or no? Now, if you say yes, you're the type of person that's willing to go through that door of opportunity and to let go of the baggage and continue on your journey with confidence. Now, in the confidence building course, the issues we deal with are stress management, we deal with social situations, we deal with communication skills, and we have goals. We learn how to do SMART goals. So you learn how to make these goals become a reality in your life, to become little successes on your journey of confidence. Now, we also have an addition, a portfolio that we do for a short accredited qualification. The course is fun, the course is engaging, and there's been many, many successes, and people's lives have turned around during this course. I hope this is giving you some information about the course. And if you have any questions, please contact the college and have a very, very good day. Thank you.
So as well as Mary's confidence building course, we also run a few other courses on the In Mind program. In Mind are courses aimed at people who are feeling stressed, worried, or low, and we offer these courses free to West Berkshire residents to support positive well-being. Learning new skills in a supportive environment can be very beneficial, can have a really beneficial effect on well-being, and our In Mind courses are designed to support learners with mild to moderate mental health disorders. Some of the courses on offer are ceramics, craft, confidence building, as you've seen in the video clip, and a soap making course. And here is Claire to tell you a little bit more about the soap making course.
So I teach the soap making courses at Newbury College, and in the new academic year, we're going to be offering the course as part of our In Mind programme, as well as continuing with the one day workshops that we currently run. In the In Mind soap making sessions, we'll learn how to create natural organic scented soaps using the melt and pour soap making method. We'll look at the melt and pour process in more detail, look at using different soap making tools, experiment with different types of colours, including liquid and powder colours, to see the different effects that that produces. And we'll cover a range of different techniques. So we'll start off by making simple one colour soaps, and then we moved on to more advanced techniques, such as layering, marbling, and look at mixing essential oils to create your own unique scent blend. And you don't need to have any experience with soap making. The course is designed for complete beginners, and we will cover all the basics of soap making using the melt and pour method. And new for the 2021 academic year, we will be offering a range of level 2 qualification courses. There are 3 pre-access courses: preparing for further study in health, social care and social work, preparing for further study in business, and preparing for further study in education. So these courses are ideal for someone who is looking for to do an access course, but maybe isn't quite ready yet. So the pre-access course will give you all the skills required to go on and complete your access course and then move on into higher education. There are several other level 2 qualification courses in crafts, employability and digital skills. These could be a progression option. So we have a number of students who have completed entry 3 and level 1 qualifications. So if you're now maybe looking for your next step, these are the courses that would be designed for you. If you're looking to build or enhance your existing skills and boost your CV, our courses in employability would be ideal. Or it could just be something completely new. So it's a subject that you're interested in and you would like to gain a qualification rather than attending one of our leisure courses. More information about these courses will be added to our website soon, with all the date, times and fee information included. So we really hope you are interested in enrolling in one of our courses. All of the courses we've discussed today, along with our entire programme, can be found on our website, and you can submit an application to your course of choice there. If you've got any other questions, please email either myself or Sarah Hemmings, who is the curriculum manager for this area. Both of our emails are on screen at the moment, and we'll be more than happy to answer any queries that you've got.
Thank you very much, Claire. I'm going to pop you live so people get to see your beautiful face. There we go. There's lots of courses on offer. I was wondering if you could have a little chat with me about how we've had to adapt regarding the COVID pandemic, and how that is going to affect courses in September going forward to the new year.
So the majority of our courses at the moment, we're planning to run them blended learning style. So that will mean the majority of your courses will be delivered online, and you will have live teaching via Microsoft Teams. And there will be a number of face-to-face sessions, but the amount of students that are allowed to come to college in these sessions will be limited. So students will come in on a rota basis, and those people who aren't in college face-to-face will be able to interact and join in with the class via Microsoft Teams.
Fantastic. So there's not really going to be any reason for me not to start a course in September. The options are still all there.
Yeah, all of our courses are going to be going ahead, just made a few adaptations so that we can adhere to the current guidelines.
Fantastic, thank you. There is a question about the level 2 qualification. You said there were some pre-access courses. Can you explain a little bit about who they might be suitable for?
So if you're interested in doing an access course and you either don't feel quite prepared, or you maybe don't have the qualifications the correct entry requirements to join that course. You can do a pre-access course, and that gives you all the skills and gives you a level two qualification, which means you're then able to access an access course and continue on to higher education.
And so an access course is really a stepping stone into higher education if maybe you've been out of study for a little while. So pre-access is kind of a further preparation in advance of continuing your study into higher education. So maybe if you've had a pause of study or, you know, lifestyle changes, etc.
Yeah, exactly.
Fantastic. I've got a question for Tanya, so I'll give you a break from the screen, put Tanya live. Hi Tanya, we've had a question for you about ceramics. Can I make anything during my session, or are we given specific projects?
So in the beginning of the course, we work together as a unit where we I give you specific things to make, where you will learn specific techniques in making that piece. And we do that until all the beginning stages of the techniques and skills are learnt. About halfway through the course, you are giving free rein to make whatever you want using the skills and techniques that we have learnt at the beginning part of the course. So there is a bit of structure at the beginning of the course, I'd say the first half of the first course, and towards the second half of the first course, yes, it opens up to you being able to make anything you like based on what we've learned.
Sounds exciting, thank you. And obviously the pandemic has meant a lot of people withdrawing and being inside to staying safe. Can you tell us a little bit more about the confidence building courses? Are they something that we can apply for directly, or do you have to go via the doctor to apply or get permission to apply?
I'm going to hand that one over to Claire, who might be able to answer that question. Sorry, I don't know the
That's
answer.
Fine. There we go, that's why we've got you all here.
Yep.
So for our in-mind courses, when you apply for the course, you'll be sent a short questionnaire that we just get you to fill in and send that back to us, and that will tell us whether you're suitable for the course. So they are aimed at people who have either mild to moderate depression or anxiety. So the questionnaire we sent you is just a short two-page questionnaire that you fill in and send back. It's kept completely confidential, so about anything.
Fantastic, thank you. And we've got a question for Sean here as well. So we'll give Sean a there we go. So your social media for business courses, one of our attendees, they're just starting a new business. How do you think they can benefit from doing your course?
So one of the best things about the course is that you will meet other people who have small businesses. We get to share ideas, find out actually what we know about those social networks, and then improve our knowledge of what social networks we should be using. There are so many different social networks, social media platforms out there. It's quite difficult, especially, you know, if you're just starting out in business, you own your own small business, even if you've been doing it for years or even decades, and now, what I always say to the students is, just because you're not using social media, it doesn't mean that your customers aren't. So just because you're not on Facebook doesn't mean that your business isn't. And it's really important actually that you understand how that works, that you can be proactive, and also that you can attract a new audience to your business by using these platforms.
Definitely. Fantastic. Thank you very much, Sean. So that's me then. Just want to say thank you to Claire, Tanya and Sean for joining us and giving us more information, to all the tutors that were featured on the video. Don't forget you can go online at newbury-college.ac.uk/adults/community and find out about all of our community courses on offer. And we thank you very much for taking the time to be with us today. You can watch this again at any time and share with your friends. Hope to see you in September, whether that's virtually or in person. Take care. Bye-bye.